हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय क्लास। इन द लास्ट क्लास आई हैव डिस्कस्ड सम प्रॉब्लम्स बेस्ड ऑन डाइवर्जेंस, कर्ल एंड ग्रेडियंट। वी विल डिस्कस फ्यू मोर प्रॉब्लम्स रिलेटेड टू दैट, देन वी विल गो टू द सम इम्पोर्टेंट थ्योरम्स एंड आइडेंटिटीज। ओके फाइन। द फर्स्ट प्रॉब्लम विल बी दैट इज रिलेटेड टू द हार्मोनिक फंक्शंस। Show that Laplacian of 1 by r is equal to 0. Okay, fine. The problem as follows. Show that Laplacian of 1 by r will be is equal to 0. Okay, so this problem can be solved easily. Let's see. So what is r will be here? We know as usual, r is equal to the position vector x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. R will be is equal to position vector xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap. So what is the magnitude of r? That is equal to square root of x square plus y square plus z square. Okay, fine. So these things you need to remember always. Dou by dou x of r, differentiation with respect to x is equal to I, differentiation with respect to y, sorry, this is y, is equal to j. Differentiation with respect to z is equal to k. So these things will be, you need to remember. In any problem, these things will be remain same. Now here I can take r square. R square will be is equal to x square plus y square plus z square. Differentiate with respect to x both sides, then I'll get 2r into dou r by dou x is equal to 2x. So from here xx will be cancelled, so dou r by dou x will be is equal to x by r. Similarly, I can prove dou r by dou y is equal to y by r. Dou r by dou z is equal to z by r. Okay, fine. So these are the things again you need to remember for further. And now move to the actual problem. So the actual problem will be del square 1 by r will be is equal to 0. That is our actual problem. Actual problem is del square 1 by r is equal to 0. So we know del square is what? Dou square by dou x square in Cartesian coordinates. Dou square by dou y square plus dou square by dou z square. So we use the summation method. So that means del square 1 by r I need to calculate. That means dou square by dou x square into 1 by r plus dou square by dou y square into 1 by r plus dou square by dou z square into 1 by r. Now you don't need to do all three, into any one. Then we can write the remaining. So let us take first, I'll calculate dou square by dou x square. Dou square by dou x square of 1 by r can be written as dou by dou x of, so dou by dou x of 1 by r. So what is the differentiation of 1 by r? Minus 1 by r square. Minus 1 by r square into dou r by dou x. So But what is dou r by dou x? This time we proved dou r by dou x will be is equal to x by r. So minus 1 by r square into x by r. So here what I'll have. So clearly, so dou square by dou x square into 1 by r will be is equal to dou by dou x of minus x by r cube. Now you use the division principle. In the division principle u by v method, this will be r power 6. Then r cube into d by dx, that will be minus 1. Then minus of minus plus x dou by dou x of r cube. What is the dou by dou x of r cube? So we know that the dou by dou x of r cube will be 3 r square. So finally that is equal to denominator r power 6. Then it is minus r cube plus 3x r square into dou r by dou x. Okay, don't forget this dou r by dou x. But dou r by dou x will be equal to x by r. Then from this minus r cube plus 3x r square into x by r into r power 6. R square it is cancelled. Then what I have? Minus r cube plus 3 r into x square divided by r power 6. Then further it can be written as minus 1 by r cube plus 3 x square by r power 5. So what I conclude, dou square by dou x square into 1 by r will be is equal to minus 1 by r cube plus 3 by r power 5 into x square. Similarly, dou square by dou y square into 1 by r will be is equal to minus 1 by r cube plus 3 by r power 5 into y square. So d square by dz square into 1 by r is equal to minus 1 by r cube plus 3 by r power 5 into z square. Okay, so all these things we got. Now we sum up. So with sum up only we will get the answer. So then what is the final? So del square 1 by r will be is equal to add this time manaku minus 3 by r cube plus 3 by r power 5 common this time x square plus y square plus z square. But x square plus y square plus r square. R square kada by r. So but em ostundi naaku minus 3 by r cube plus 3 by r cube. That I'll get 0. Okay. So this is what we need to prove. Okay. Be careful. So now onwards, in any problem, these things will be fixed. Whenever there is a r, these things will be fixed. So it is better to remember these things. That is useful for us in all the problems. So if r is equal to xi cap plus y zeta plus z k cap, then magnitude of r differentiation with respect to x is x by r, y is y by r, z is z by r. Then r vector differentiation with respect to x is unit vector. So better you mug up these two things. Okay, fine. I hope it is clear. You go to the next problem. The next problem as follows. The problem is show that del square of a function which is a function of r only, radial coordinate, f of r, will be is equal to d square by dr square f plus 2 by r d by dr of f. Okay, this is what we need to prove. So let's see how to prove this. So double derivative, it is only radial coordinate, it only depends upon the okay. Okay, fine. Go to that problem. Show that del square f of r is equal to d square f by dr square plus 2 by r into df by dr. So as usual, so just like in the previous problem, so in the del square we have the three components. The first component is dou square by dou x square component. So that is f of r. So this can be written as dou by dou x of f of r. Okay, fine. So when I do differentiation first time, what I'll get here? So dou by dou x f dash r into dou r by dou x. But dou r by dou x is x by r. That is equal to dou by dou x of f dash and f prime into x by r. Okay. Now we need to do again. So when I do further differentiation of this thing, so what I have is a product rule first, then u by v rule. అదే ప్రోడక్ట్ దాన్ని అది అట్లయినా చేసిద్దాం, నో ప్రాబ్లం. సో యు టేక్ లైక్ దిస్, డో బై డో ఎక్స్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్ ఇంటూ ఎఫ్ ప్రైమ్ ఈజ్ వన్ యూనిట్ బై ఆర్ ఈస్ అనదర్ యూనిట్, దెన్ దిస్ విల్ బికమ్ ఆర్ స్క్వేర్ ఆర్ ఇంటూ డో బై డో ఎక్స్ ఆఫ్ x f prime minus, and what I'll get here, x into f prime dou r by dou x. Okay, fine. So now here what I'll have, this is again the product rule. We do the product rule here. When I perform the product rule here, what I'll have? So this will be is equal to r square, perform the product rule, r into x constant dou by dou x of f prime minus f prime constant dou x by dou x. Let's go. Sorry, here it is plus. We are written product. Minus x into f prime into what is dou r by dou x? It is x by r. Okay, then I multiply here, what I'll get? So the first term divided by r square. So x into r, even I do the differentiation with respect to f prime, then here see dou by dou x of f prime will be is equal to f double prime, that is equal to f, one more time differentiation, f double prime into dou r by dou x. But what is dou r by dou x? F double prime into dou r by dou x is equal to x by r. Okay, that I put here, then r is here, that cancels, but one more x is there, x into x, it will become x square. X square into f double prime plus r into f prime minus x square into f prime by r. Okay. Now you divide with this r square everywhere, then what I'll have? X square f double prime by r square is the first term. F prime by r is the next term. So then r cube, x square divided by r cube f prime. So finally d square by dx square f of r I got. Okay, fine. Now similarly I can do for y, I can do for z. Okay, you can do for all. Similarly for y, for z. D square by dy square f of r is equal to y square into f double prime by r square plus f prime by r minus y square by r cube into f prime. D square by dz square into f of r will be equal to z square f double prime by so finally we need to sum up all these things. So when we sum up all these things, del square into f of r will be equal to, in the first term f double prime by r square is common, so I'll get x square plus y square plus z square. In the next term all three terms will come, 3 f prime divided by r. In the next, I'm sorry, in the next what I have, minus common, f prime by r cube common, then I have x square plus y square plus z square. Okay, here also it is plus. Okay, fine. Now after simplification, substituting x square plus y square plus z square is equal to r square. Substitute that one, then this will become f double prime r square here plus 3 f prime by r minus f prime by r cube into r square. So first term is f double prime, then second one is 3 f prime by r minus f prime by r. So one time cancel, then I have f double prime plus 2 by r into f. Okay, prime means it is differentiation here. So finally we can write this will be like this. So del square f of r will be equal to d square by dr square into f of r 2 by r into, one more time differentiation, d by dr of this is what we need to. So actually this is very helpful when we deal the del square in spherical coordinates. When we deal the del square in spherical coordinates, that time it helps a lot. We can break this into two components, radial component, angular theta component and phi component, azimuthal angle. So radial part will comes out to be somewhat like this. Okay, so that is the importance of this problem. Okay, so I'll go to the another problem. The next problem as follows. So based on divergence and curl, the problem as follows. the problem will be first. Find divergence and curl of a vector field. Divergence and curl of a vector field where f is equal to some r power n into r vector. Second problem will be show that f is irrotational. Third problem will be for what value, so find for which value of n it is solenoid. Find n such that f is solenoidal. So it consists three parts. So let us solve the problem. So first part of the problem is very simple. So I am taking the divergence of f. So the first part of the problem is divergence of f is del dot r power n into r. Okay, then it is again a summation. Three terms will be there. I have the summation formula sigma I dot product with dou by dou x of r power n into r. Okay, then here, then we use the product rule here, sigma I dot product with product rule. First term is constant, dou by dou x of r, then r constant, dou by dou x of r power n. So from here, so this will be is equal to sigma I dot, here it is r power n into dou r by dou x will be I cap. This is I said many times, you remember these things, plus r power n n into r power n minus 1 of course into dou r by dou x into r vector is there, don't forget. Okay, fine. Then what is the next? The next will be that is equal to sigma I dot r power n into I cap plus n into r power n minus 1. What is dou r by dou x? X by r. So this is r power minus 1 goes up, then r power n minus 2, that is equal to sigma I dot dot product r power n into I plus n into r power n minus 2 x into r. Now you can use the summation formula. Oh, don't use, first you take the dot product with this. The first term will become r power n is a scalar, you don't need to do I dot I. Next, x is scalar, n is scalar, r power n minus 2 is scalar, then I dot r. Okay, so the still summation is there, don't forget this summation. Still the summation is there. Then what will be the next term? I dot I will be 1. So I dot I will be 1. Is sigma r power n I dot I is 1, then plus what is I dot r? I dot r will be x, so x component, that is x into x, x square, x square into n into r power n minus 2. Now you repeat the terms, So we want all the terms now. Therefore, del square. Divergence. Divergence of r power n into r will be is equal to first term. It will come 3 times, so it will be 3 power r power n. So in the next term, y square into this much, z square into this much will come. So if I take n into r power n minus 2 common, first term will be x square plus y square plus z square. That I'll get as r square. Then r square r power minus 2 will cancel. Then it will be 3 into r power n plus n into r power n. Okay. R power n I can pull out, so that I'll get n plus 3 into r power n. That's what. Okay, that's over. This is the first part of the problem is clear. Then go to the second part of the problem. What is the second part of the problem? The cross product. Okay, let us go to the cross product. Curl. So second part of the problem is a curl. It is not second problem, it is the second part. The second part of the problem will be now curl del cross r power n into r. Okay, so this can be written as summation term only. Summation I cap cross first term will be do by do x of r power n into r. Okay, then what I'll get here, so this will be is equal to anyway r power n is a constant, you pull out. I can't, because after differentiation only we can put sigma I cross, do the differentiation. First put r power n constant, then do the dou r by dou x, then plus r constant, then do the dou by dou x of r power n. Then this will be sigma I cross r power n. Dou r by dou x will be I cap plus r into n into r power n minus 1 dou r by dou x. So dou r by dou x will be x by r. Then what I will have? Sigma I cross here r power n into I cap plus n into r into, but this is, what is this quantity? X by r. 1 r power minus 1 cancel. R into simply x now. Okay, now you take the cross product inside. When I take the cross product inside, sigma notation will be first term is I cross I, that is 0. Second term will be n constant, r constant, x constant, r. So then what I'll have? N R X constant. Then that will be okay, just a second. problem. Just a second. Yeah, now it's working. Let's move to the one. So two, that is n r x I cross r. But I cross I is zero. But I cross r. Then I cross product with r. That is x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. Then first term I cross I will be zero. Second term I cross j is k. Y into k cap. Then next term I cross k is minus j. Then so this is this term. This will be y k cap minus z j cap. So with this, what if this will become now finally? So that will become sigma. First term is 0, n into r into, when I multiply with x, xy k cap minus xz j cap. Okay. Now we repeat for all the terms. So release that sigma. The first term, n r common in everywhere. The first term will be x y k cap minus x z j cap. Okay. Next here, what it will come? Y will come. Then j cross r will come. Okay. J cross r. Then what I'll get that j cross r? J cross product with r. X I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. So j cross I minus k x k plus j cross j 0, j cross k I z I. But we need to multiply with y. When I multiply with y, I'll get minus x y k cap plus y z I cap. The next term will be, here it is n r z will come, k cross r. So when I do the k cross r, k cross r, x I cap y j cap plus z k cap. K cross I, I j k, k cross I, what I'll get? J x j, k cross j minus I, k cross k will be 0, but z is there here, I multiply with z. X z j cap minus y z I cap. This is. So now you can see here some terms will be cancelled with each other. So x y k cap is here. The same thing, x y minus k cap. So cancel each other. Then minus x z k cap. So plus xz j cap, cancel each other. Then yz I cap minus yz I cap. Then finally what I am getting here. So n r into 0, thus entire thing will be 0. So what a conclusion we can make here. The conclusion will be curl of a vector is 0. That is the conclusion. What is the conclusion here? Curl of a vector is 0. Once curl of a vector is 0, we call it irrotational. F is irrotational. This much we need to prove in the second part of the problem. Okay. Now, this is the second part of the problem. So, now you go to the third part of the problem. The third part of the problem is, for what values it is a solenoidal? We know that the condition for solenoidal is divergence of f will be is equal to 0. So see above we have calculated divergence of f. So what is the divergence of f we got? divergence of f we got as divergence of r power n, n plus 3 into r power n. Okay, n plus 3 into r power n. That should be equal to 0 according to the problem. Solenoid, n plus 3 into r power n. Okay, let's see, n plus 3 into r power n is 0. So, solenoidal, n plus 3 into, sorry, we got here, n plus 3 into r power n. N plus 3 into r power n, yeah. N plus 3 into r power n. N plus 3 into r power n is equal to 0. Obviously here we have n plus 3 is equal to 0 and r power n is not equal to 0. So n is equal to minus 3. For n is equal to minus 3, the given field is a solenoidal. Okay, so that means f is equal to r power n into r. So now you substitute n is minus 3. R power minus 3 r, that is r by r cube. So it is solenoidal. Whenever it is r by r cube, then it will be a solenoid. Okay, fine. That's it. This is the problem. It's a good problem. We'll go to the another problem. The next problem as follows. The next problem as follows. The problem is, show that, next problem is, show that del square r power n will be is equal to n into n plus 1 into r power n. This we need to prove. Okay, fine. Then again we follow the sigma notation. Del square r power n will be is equal to summation of, three terms will be there. The first term is dou square by dou x square into r power n. So this can be written as sigma dou by dou x of r power n, but r power n differentiation will be, so r power n differentiation will be n into r power n minus 1 dou r by dou x. But what is the dou r by dou x? It is x by r. That sigma dou by dou x into x by r, n into r power n minus 1 x by r. So r power n minus 2 will come, that is sigma dou by dou x of n into x into r power n minus 2. Okay, fine. So now here what I can do, sorry, here it will be, so one, so again I need to do the differentiation, but n is constant, it can comes out sigma n into then dou by dou x of x into r power n minus 2. Okay, now we'll do the differentiation. Sigma notation, sigma n into, the first term is x constant, dou by dou x of r power n minus 2 plus r power n minus 2 is constant, dou by dou x of x, sigma n into r power n minus 2, x into n into x power n minus 1, r power n minus 3, antena, that's it, yeah. So into dou r by dou x, don't forget this, into dou r by dou x, n into x power n minus 1 into dou r by dou x, plus r power n minus 2 with dou by dou x is 1. But dou r by dou x is x by r. Then here x square will come. Here n power minus 4 will come. Okay. So this is sigma notation n. Dou r by dou x by r. R power minus 1. N minus 2 into x square into r power n minus 4. Plus r power n minus 2. So now you expand the summation. When I expand the summation, what I'll get here? So now expand the summation. Now del square r power n will be equal to, and I expand the summation, but n will be outside. That is there. Then first term will be n power minus 2 r power n minus 4 common. N power minus 2 r power n minus 4 common. Then first term is x square, second term is y square, next term will be z square. But here it is 3 times will come r power n minus 2. So then what I'll have here? Del square r power n will be is equal to n into, here it is n minus 2 into, this is r square, that means r power n minus 2 plus 3 into r power n minus 2. Now r power n minus 2 comes out, r into n into r power n minus 2. Here it is n minus 2 plus 3. N minus 2 plus 3 means it is 1. So n into n plus 1 into r power n minus 2. That is del square r power n. Okay, so hence the result is proved. So I think question we wrote wrongly. N into n plus 1 r power n minus 2, it is print mistake in the question only. Here it is n minus 2. Minus 2. It is print mistake in our textbook itself. N into n plus 1 into r power n minus 2. So in this way we can solve the problems related to divergence, curl and gradients. Okay, fine. In the next class we will see some vector identities or theorems, in the form of theorems we will solve. Okay, fine. Thank you. Thank you. Fine, thank you.